About 10 years ago, antiangiogenic agents were really the hottest topic in lung cancer. There was data from the E4599 study that showed a survival benefit as well as a benefit for progression-free survival and objective response rate when bevacizumab was added to carboplatin and paclitaxel. Then, for a variety of reasons, enthusiasm has waned somewhat for this class of agents, although the data has certainly not changed, and there still appears to be, at least along with carboplatin and paclitaxel, a benefit with the addition of angiogenesis inhibitors. There, in the United States, is one other agent that is also available, ramucirumab. In Europe, in addition, there is an agent, an oral agent, nintedanib, which is available for patients with adenocarcinoma. And much of what I discussed was really the differences between the data between the two agents and why one is unavailable in the United States and Europe, whereas the other one is really only available in the United States.